Many have asked, is Jesus God? Has Jesus ever claimed to be God? Is there any proof in the Bible that Jesus is God? I'm happy to say yes. Let's examine five of these proofs right now. Proof number one. First and foremost, the highest authority in the universe, God the Father, calls Jesus God. It's found in Psalm 45, verse 6, and it is also in Hebrews 1, 8, which says, But unto the Son he saith, Thy throne, O God, is forever and ever. A scepter of righteousness is the scepter of thy kingdom. Proof number two, Jesus confirmed that he is God when the high priest spoke the words found in Mark 14, 61 and 62, saying, Art thou the Christ, the Son of the Blessed? And Jesus said, I am, and you shall see the Son of Man sitting on the right hand of power and coming in the clouds of heaven. Jesus' response, I am, is the same response Moses received at the burning bush when he asked God what his name was. And Exodus 3, 14 through 15 records God saying unto Moses, I am that I am. And he said, Thou shalt say unto the children of Israel, I am, hath sent me unto you. And God said moreover unto Moses, Thus shalt thou say unto the children of Israel, The Lord God of your fathers, the God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, and the God of Jacob, hath sent me unto you. This is my name forever, and this is my memorial unto all generations. This is why the high priest was so angry at Jesus and accused him of blasphemy, because in responding this way, Jesus confirmed that he was not only the Son of God, but that he is the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. This may be a new revelation to you, but the Bible clearly reveals Jesus was an active member of the Godhead during the events of the Old Testament, leading his people to the promised land through Moses. In fact, under the inspiration of the Holy Spirit, the Apostle Paul verifies in Corinthians 10, 1 through 11, that Jesus was in the wilderness with Moses and the Israelites. Be sure to read 1 Corinthians 10, 1 through 11. Paul comes right out in verse 4 and says that the spiritual rock which followed them in the wilderness was Christ. Paul also tells us in verse 9 that the Israelites in the wilderness tempted Christ and were destroyed of serpents. Proof number three, by asking his disciples, Who do men say that I am? Jesus affirmed Peter's heaven-born revelation that Jesus is the Christ in Matthew 16, 16 and 17, saying, Thou art the Christ, the Son of the living God. And Jesus answered and said unto him, Blessed art thou, Simon Barjona, for flesh and blood hath not revealed it unto thee, but my Father which is in heaven. Proof number four, in the book of Luke, Jesus, speaking of both his divinity and his humanity, tells us why he came to this earth. Jesus said in Luke 19:10, For the Son of Man is come to seek and to save that which was lost. Now let me ask you, who but God could save the lost? The answer is found in Acts 4:12, which says concerning Jesus, Neither is there salvation in any other, for there is none other name under heaven given among men whereby we must be saved. Christians who believe the Bible will agree, God is the Creator. But did you know it was Jesus and not the Father who created all things? Here is proof number five. Who is Jesus? Look at this interesting text found in John chapter 1, 1 and 3, which says, In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. All things were made by Him. According to this text, the Word, who was with God, and who was God, created all things. But who is the Word? The Bible tells us in John 1:14, which says, And the Word was made flesh and dwelt among us. The only person of the Godhead that was made flesh was Jesus. Therefore, Jesus is the Word. Jesus is the Creator. If there is any doubt, Hebrews 1:1-2 says, God, who at various times and in different manners spoke in time past unto the fathers by the prophets, has in these last days spoken unto us by his Son, whom he has appointed heir of all things, by whom also he made the worlds. Also speaking about Jesus, Colossians 1:16 says, For by him were all things created, that are in heaven and that are in earth, visible and invisible, whether they be thrones or dominions or principalities or powers, all things were created by him and for him. Revelation 14:7 encourages us to worship Him that made heaven and earth, the sea, and the fountains of waters. In other words, we are to worship Jesus, the Creator of heaven and earth. Jesus said in Matthew 28:18-20, "All power is given unto me in heaven and in earth. Go ye therefore and teach all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost, teaching them to observe all things whatsoever I have commanded you. And lo, I am with you always, even unto the end of the world. Amen." Free book offer for The Great Controversy. Simply email stmedia.co@gmail.com. Inside the continental United States, provide name and address for the hard copy while supplies last. Outside the continental United States, you will receive the PDF version by return email. Please do not request this book if you already have a copy in your home.